understand.
Yeah.
I mean, hey, I had a great show. I loved it. And
what it means, but it's pretty.
I think it melted into the, what we didn't want to do.
Grew up and became working pretty much on a blank canvas.
So what do you want to know?
I want to play golf.
There is only one road I'm walking.
I want to have a child.
Chercher son âme dans les froids, dans les flammes. Je te jetterai des sorts pour que tu m'aimes encore.
I want to drive my own car.
I'm falling into you. This dream could.
I want to cook. I want to go to the groceries and buy my own tomatoes. I just want to have a normal life for a while.
Blessed with one of pop's most powerful voices, Celine Dion has conquered the planet, selling more than 100 million albums worldwide. She's earned music industry accolades from all over the world, including 5 Grammys, 7 Billboard Awards, and 3 American Music Awards. And in a stunning achievement, she's the first female artist ever in the UK to achieve 3 consecutive number one albums. She's become one of the biggest stars in the world of popular music. Now at the age of 31, and after a demanding 15 years in the business, Celine Dion has decided to hang up her mic and take a well-deserved break. To celebrate a decade of unrivaled success, she released a collection of her biggest hits, All the Way, a Decade of Song.
You've been talking about retiring. You're going to take a break for a while.
Yeah.
Is this a way to sort of leave them with something to remember you by for the next little while?
Well, I hope so, because if I wouldn't think so, I wouldn't have done it. But I hope it's a good way for me to say I'll be gone for a little while. My only way for me to express my gratitude or express my feelings or my thoughts, or it's through music. There's no any other way for me. So I've used music another time in my life to say thank you and to express what I feel. I wanted to have some new songs and the record company, and I wanted to have some greatest hits at the same time. So two albums in one, in a way. So we got 7 new songs and 9 greatest hits.
Hi, I'm Maurice Gibb.
I'm Barry Gibb.
And I'm Robin Gibb, and we're the Bee Gees.
We wrote a song for Celine Dion called Immortality. She inspired the song, she inspires us. Probably the finest female pop singer in the world.
Yeah,
it was a dream that she might sing one of our songs one day, and that was, and the dream came true.
So this is who I am, and this is all I know, and I must choose to live for all that I can give. Spark that makes the fire grow.
When we came into the studio, it was the first night we'd heard her sing the song, and it just blew everyone away. And when you're a songwriter and you have this happen with such a great voice like Celine's, it's just indescribable how you feel emotionally. This is one night we won't forget. It's been incredible.
Certain as the sun,
certain as the sun,
rising in the
long as roll as one.
When I did Beauty and the Beast, I knew it was a good song because I wanted to do it and I felt right. I saw the movie. I don't know too much about Walt Disney because I didn't grow up with cartoons and movies too much. I went to see the movie first. I freaked out. It was so beautiful. And they invited me to sing with Peebo. I sang with him. We had a good time and then it came out. And I consider today that I've been part of a classic, and I've been very lucky to be part of a classic. It's started my whole career, and it's going to be with me for the rest of my life.
There were nights when the wind was so cold that my body froze in bed if I just listened to it right outside the window.
The song, It's All Coming Back to Me, it's probably the biggest song I've ever recorded in my career. Working with Jim Steinman was an incredible experience. It was exciting, it was different. When you hear that song, it sounds so big, so huge, the words, the music, it's like a musical. I think a lot of people would have loved to have this song, and I feel very fortunate that he gave it to me.
And I banished every memory you and I had ever made. Maybe.
Don't say what you're about to say.
No, 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 no.
The producer of the song, Christopher Neal, came to Morin Nights in Montreal. It's a big studio in the Laurentians. We have recorded the song together. And Aldo Nova joined us, another producer, who we all did our. We all put our talent together and made the song sound as good as possible. And I guess it pleased a lot of people.
I'm just very amazed about every time I start, every time they hear the flute, doo, 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 and they freak out.
Every night in my dreams, I see you, I feel you. That is how I know you. Go on.
The Titanic song, it became the people's song. You know, when they get married, when they do something, it's their song. So when it starts, they can't wait for that song. It's in their heart, and I'm very proud to be able to come on stage and sing what they want to hear.
Near, far,
and I'm once again so thankful for that song and so proud that I'm part of it. It's going to stay with me for the rest of my life.
As well as her biggest hits, the album also includes 7 brand new songs. Having gained a career singing mostly ballads, the first single was an up-tempo track and demonstrates Celine's desire to simply try out something new.
I can read your mind and I know.
Coming with an up-tempo song, so refreshing, video and casual clothing, and it was wonderful because I'm the happiest now in my life. And I've never felt so powerful and at the same time so light. And I couldn't see myself coming back with another ballad or another Titanic. There is one Titanic song. There's not two. And I've been known as a ballad singer, which I agree, which I like very much. But coming back just to say, see you soon, I hope,
I'm hitting my life for the first time. I'm going to boating and golfing and cooking and do everything I haven't done. But ciao, see you soon. I'm happy about this. This is what I want. With an up-tempo song and say, and that's the way it is. And it's happy.
When you want it the most.
When I shoot a video, it's always very complicated. I'm always losing my boyfriends, I'm always crying, I'm always bare feet, I'm always miserable, and I'm always crying, and I'm always alone in the world. It's not true. I love shoes, I'm the happiest in the world, I'm surrounded with lots of people, I'm married, and I'm gonna get married again with the same guy, I'm happy like crazy, and every time I come home, I'm with thousands of people. So refreshing to work with Liz on one plateau, which one picture, very modern, almost zen, simple, no surfer guys, which I like, but it's not necessarily my style. I'm not losing anybody, and I'm just focused on me. Casual shoes, casual pants, great shirt, wonderful.
Deeper than the deep blue sea is, that's how deep it goes, if it's real.
When somebody needs
when
you,
somebody
it's no
needs
good unless
you. It's no good unless she needs you.
All the way.
Talk to me about that song. Tell me why you decided to put that on. And
it's one of my favorite songs, one of Renee's favorite songs. We love Frank Sinatra very much. He's got the idea, Renee. Just too bad you couldn't sing with him. I said, you're right. It didn't take him long. He called Mrs. Sinatra. And he said, would love to sing with him, would love to do something with him. She was happy about it, and he called David Foster, put everything together, and we went on with it, and it was a great experience. I loved it.
Was it strange hearing your voices,
Steve? Not strange. It was very... I didn't have to do much. He took me. He took me. He was there, big time. I love those seven songs that I picked. They said, we love that song and we think it's a good song to start with. Hey, I'm your partner anytime. I agree. And I think they did a good choice because, like I said to you a second ago, I'm so happy and it just finished with a high note and say, hopefully I'll be back, but I feel so good.
Celine Dion's story has passed into showbiz legend. The youngest of 14 children from a working-class Canadian family, she started her career singing on a table in the family bar when she was just 5 years old. 7 years later, her family sent a demo tape to local manager René Angelil, who was so impressed by what he heard, he mortgaged his house to finance Celine's debut. In 1994, after a secret courtship, René, 26 years her senior, took his best client to the altar and they were married.
I'm gonna run back, 'cause baby, I need you here beside me.
He's been loving me from day one, supporting me, respecting me. He's been an artist himself. He's been on stage before me, so he's not only saying, you'll be fine, honey, you know. He knows what I'm going through. When I'm tired, when I'm sick, when I lose my voice, when I'm afraid, when I can't wait to go back on stage. He knows.
At the turn of the millennium, Celine and René had even more to celebrate. On the 5th of January at 5 in the afternoon, 5 years after they first wed, the world's most famous couple stepped up to the altar and renewed their wedding vows. In distinct contrast to the traditional ceremony in Montreal, the wedding was an extravaganza. And true to form, it took place in the showbiz capital of the world.
We're bringing the whole family to Las Vegas for a gift, actually. And it's a lot of people in my family, they've never traveled and they've never been to Vegas, so it's an exciting town, so we're going to bring everybody, we're going to be something like 250 people to Vegas, and we're going to celebrate over there. We're going to do a little kind of a private show for them and have a good time.
'Cause I'm your lady.
Get remarried?
Well, at first I just thought of that just for fun, as a joke almost. And then I said, no, it's not that crazy. You know, 5 years, five's a lucky number, 5 of January, everybody's there. Let's do a party. Let's get married again. And you know what? I've been married to my manager for 5 years, and you've been married to the singer. Well, I'm going to get married to my husband, and he's going to get married to his wife. So we're going to meet for the first time.
For all the times you stood by me, for all the truth that you made me see, for all the joy you brought to my life.
When we choose to get married 5 years ago, we promised before man and God to help each other and to be totally committed and devoted through the good and bad times, in sickness and in health. The past year and its sadness and worries made me realize the power of those vows. My love, I'm promising again that I will always be there for you no matter what. I love you more each day and forever.
When I was weak, you were my voice when I couldn't speak. You were my eyes when I couldn't see. You saw the best there was in me.
The romantic celebration also marked the beginning of an extensive break in Celine's so far non-stop career. She would give her last public performance just a few days before on New Year's Eve in Montreal.
My last show is the 31st of December, and I'm going to do a big party in Montreal with the first people who applaud me in Montreal, my first fans, my family, friends. It's going to be like a big party. We're there to have a good time.
Her decision to bow out of all public appearances and produce no new albums at a time when she's on a crest of her career is a deeply personal one. Renée, who has managed her career since she was just 12 years old, has been diagnosed with skin cancer. And faced with the shock of his illness, Celine has had no hesitation in putting her own commitments firmly on the back burner.
I guess it makes all of us, both of us actually, realize that stopping planning the future but live one day at a time. And not only that he loves me very much, but now he needs me. And for a human being to be needed is the most extraordinary thing. I feel needed, and I love that. I feel powerful, and I can make a difference.
I'm falling into you. This dream could come true, and it feels so good.
You've been with him for a very, very long time.
That's right. I know him for 18 years.
Could you be without him?
Absolutely not. Absolutely not. I mean, of course, he's older than me, and everybody loses people that they love one day. You lose, I lose. You never know what's going to happen. Am I going to die tomorrow? Nobody knows. But I'm definitely not thinking about this, and I'm living each day so powerful, so intense, that it's just incredible. Whatever he gave me so much that I can go on for the rest of my life without even thinking about it.
Now that Renee's condition has responded to treatment, for the next few years, the couple plan to travel on their own. And superstar Celine, well, she's looking forward to doing things that most of us simply take for granted.
Just want to have a normal life for a while, have no pressure, have no discipline, because I've been disciplined all my life, very much with my voice, training every day, and I'm just looking forward to not training, don't have any, I can have dairy products every day of my life if I want for a couple of years at least. I want to play golf, I want to have a child, I want to drive my own car, I want to cook, I want to go to the groceries and buy my own tomatoes.
Today at 31 years of age, Celine Dion has love, money and success beyond her wildest dreams. But since marrying her husband back in 1994, one ambition has far outweighed the rest.
And you mentioned having a kid.
Yeah.
One, two, you want to...
I don't know, but it, not 14.
You've done that.
Yeah, not 14, maybe three, maybe... But let's start with one and see how it goes.
Hello, comment ça va?
The drive to have a family. I know you grew up in a very strong French-Canadian family,
mm-hmm.
you know, very, very close-knit,
yes.
a bunch of kids. What do you remember about being a kid and growing up in that environment that makes you want to start your own family?
Oh. Happiness and love and affection, attention, music. When I think about it, I still feel the floor, hearing my brothers and sisters in the basement of the house playing instruments every day. And I was on the second floor, and I could feel the floor. I could smell the cooking of my mother. And I could see kids and instruments everywhere. And it was fun. Arguments, but just kids towards kids. Parties, people, full house. A full house all the time. But lots of fun. It's, I don't know, it's like four seasons every day. Some are crying, some are in love, some are just laughing, some are partying, some are just, I don't know, there's so many different souls in one house and different characters, and it was unbelievable to grow up in that beautiful family. I'm very fortunate.
You want it the most.
Welcome to the overall best-selling artist, Celine Dion.
You've been hugely successful. Is there any thoughts in your mind that, you know, getting back into it in 2, 3, 5, 10 years, are you insecure about that?
Not at all. Not at all, because when you have your health, your happiness, your friends, your family, and a foundation. It can be the end of the world tomorrow. A bomb can just fall beside me. I don't regret anything in the past, in my life. I feel very fortunate that I could do what I always wanted to do. And I have lots of wonderful people surrounding me. No matter what happens, if I come back and it's over for me, it's all right, because I know at home something's waiting for me.